will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikilikimaka is the wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you, our one audience member. We appreciate that. And thank you to the listeners out there. We're so happy to be on here tonight. As I said before, we're kind of a group of amateur musicians. We do have a professional in our midst, but we'll get to that maybe a little bit later in the show. But we just get together every Wednesday. We read some music out of a book. We have some fun. And this is just a fraction of our kind of our group here. I think we're going to go right into our next one.
Could I make a request?
Yeah, of course.
So you did Mele Kalikimaka, and I was wondering, as you do these, if you could maybe just mention either who popularized them or how you know them, because maybe a song is a Bing Crosby cover, but somebody who's 12 years old might not know that, or somebody who's 72 years old might not know that. So just if you maybe think to mention it, I think it would be enriching, and also I wouldn't have to swoop in, and because I also sometimes want to know, but I don't want to interrupt. So.
No worries. So that one, I know it as a Bing Crosby cover myself, and that's kind of the way I like to sing it. But do we like any other versions, group?
I found one I liked by Bette Midler.
Bette Midler?
Yeah. Well, she's from Hawaii, so...
She is?
She, I believe, was born there and grew up there, and that's where her school music teacher told her she had a voice like a frog.
Oh, no.
And I'm sure she has laughed about it every day since getting rich.
Laughing all the way to the bank.
Yes.
Oh, Christmas Vacation.
Oh, yeah, that's kind of a... Yeah, on Christmas Vacation, that is definitely a... I remember seeing that when I was too young to see that scene.
Is this National Lampoon's?
Yeah, National Lampoon's.
I was waiting until I was old enough. I guess I can go ahead.
It's a much faster version.
Well, I didn't mean to throw you off your rhythm. Whatever you have next, I'm certainly ready to hear it. But do mention who you are one more time just for people.
Yeah, we are the CUU Uke Jam. You can find us on Facebook at Champagne-Urbana Ukulele Jam. Feel free to join our group. We meet on Wednesdays at the Phillips Recreation Center in Urbana. That will be moved to Thursdays in January. But hey, if you join the Facebook group, you'll know that right away. So... our next song is going to be Feliz Navidad, and then I think afterwards we'll introduce some of our bandmates here.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
All right, does anybody know who wrote that one or popularized it? Because I do not. Jose Feliciano is what I'm hearing. Okay. Thank you for that one, Jose. That is such a great Christmas song.
May I just add one thing? Mm-hmm. I heard many Christmas songs today, and I think that was the only one where I heard the original version rather than some modern interpretation of it. And there is a term for a song that is multilingual. And I was trying to remember it this afternoon, and it was just, it was right on the tip of my tongue, and all I could think of was the Spanish word for Christmas carols, because I believe they're very similar words. Does anybody know offhand what it is?
Mm-mm.
Well, I was going to look it up anyway, and I think I will, and I'll come back with it later. The Spanish word for Christmas carols is villancicos, at least in southern Spain. Mm-hmm. But he is from Puerto Rico, so that may or may not carry over. But, yeah, there is a term for a song that starts in one language and goes through other languages. And so that was timely. Anyhow, I should leave you to what you were going to jump to next. But I just heard, does anybody know who sang that? And I'm like, well, kind of, but...
All right, so our next one's going to be Blue Christmas. Ooh. And I think this is a good time to recognize the fact that we're a lot of us are beginners, or at least started out as beginners, you know, not more than 1 or 2 years ago. And we're actually playing a majority of our music tonight out of kind of a beginner's guide to Christmas music by a woman named Cynthia Lynn. She has a very popular YouTube channel. You can get her Christmas book online for free. Just type in Cynthia Lynn Christmas book into Google. You'll find it right away. It's a really great resource, and actually all of those songs have their own YouTube video to show you how to play them too. So it's a really great way, maybe if you get a ukulele for the holidays, to kind of get into the spirit. And we'll also be starting a absolute beginner ukulele class starting in January, and I'll talk a little bit more about that soon. But without further ado, let's go ahead and do Blue Christmas, popularized by Elvis Presley. And we may or may not be doing a little bit of a kind of an Elvis voice on this one. We'll see.
You decorate
without you. I'll be so blue just thinking above about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start falling, that's when those blue memories start calling. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white, but I'll have a blue, blue Christmas.
Thank you.
Sound of one hand clapping.
All right, so I think this is a good time to maybe go around the room really quick and introduce ourselves. So I'll reiterate, I'm Jacob Johnston. I like to play the electric ukulele, really fun instrument, totally electric, but I'll play the acoustic in a little bit. And if we could tell everybody kind of what we're using too, I think that'd be a lot of fun. Let's start with the front row over here.
Oh, I'm Steve. This is my first, probably my only ukulele. It's a solid koa. It was a souvenir from Maui. I went with my son 2 years ago, and I started lessons with Jacob 2 years ago, and I'm sucked into this whole group here now. I'm really enjoying it.
Yep, Steve's amazing. We love him at the jams because he always has these really intricate little kind of notes to put into the music. We call it the Steve sauce on top, and it's a lot of fun.
Could you give it a strum, Steve, so we can hear it? Awesome. And I just said that because I wanted to play. So my name is Matt Childress, and I play the Takala U-Bass. It is played exactly like an electric bass guitar, except for it is much smaller. It's about 2 feet long. It's on the body of a baritone ukulele. And it also has rubber band style strings, so it doesn't hurt my fingers, because I don't believe things should be painful. And the first time I played a bass guitar, it did not like my fingers at all. So this is what it sounds like.
My name's Kevin, and I'm playing a concert-size ukulele. It's, I think, the smallest one we have here today.
Mm-hmm. Looks like it.
And it can also plug in. We're not doing that tonight, but I could plug this into a guitar amp as well. So it's an electric acoustic concert uke. Mia?
I'm Mia. It's an ukulele. I don't know much about it.
It's an outdoor ukulele. It's really cool. You can take it canoeing with you.
Right. You can hit your sister over the head and still make good music with it.
If you went canoeing with it, would you paddle with it?
You could.
Yes. Well,
yeah.
I think it's waterproof. Yeah.
It's waterproof. It's designed to be left in the trunk of your car and played.
Which is why I will be getting one very soon. It's trunk proof. Yeah, in the trunk of my car.
I'm Terry, and I just got this beautiful Fender for my birthday on Thursday.
Woo!
And it's got a Jazzmaster body, and it's electric acoustic, and I love it. And I just need to practice so I can get better and make it sound better.
No. I'm Kayla, and I sing.
You
sing
whistle
well.
And stuff.
I whistle,
too,
yeah.
I'm Rachel Gushy. I don't play the ukulele yet, but probably in January I will start. But meanwhile, I'm shaking and jingling and singing.
Singing a lot of harmonies, which are sounding great, by the way. And one of your instruments that I like the most, I think, Rachel, is your little pear shaker.
Everybody loves my pear shaker.
Yeah, I
so
thought it was
cute.
An actual pear at first.
And
I was about to take a bite
so
out
nice.
Of it.
And it's delicious as well as functional.
All right, up next for everybody listening in, we've got Jingle Bell Rock, popularized by
Bobby Helms.
That's right, Bobby Helms.
Bobby Helms, all right.
It's a quiz show. All right, everybody ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's coming fast. Here we go.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing the bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time, dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away.
Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle and a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell rock. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing a bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time, dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time
to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle and a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell.
That's a fun one there. I like that one. All right. We kind of got what I'm hoping and what will be a showstopper for y'all at home, because if we hadn't played an earworm yet, we're going to get you with this one, we hope. All I Want for Christmas Is You, popularized by Mariah Carey herself.
This will be better.
It will be a version.
It will be live.
It will be live is what it will be.
I'm not too fast.
A not too fast version. I'm getting requests over here now. Watch out. Okay.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need,
and I
thank you.
That one's my favorite. All right, so I know we were talking a little bit about our beginner lessons, so I did want to reiterate, we're going to be, if you are somebody who is getting ukulele for the holidays, you are living in the right county. We take all kinds over at the Urbana Park District Phillips Recreation Center. So that's going to be starting on January 20th, which I believe is a Thursday. If you want more information, check out the Urbana Park District Program Guide. It's in there under Age-Friendly Programs.
I have a specific question. Mm-hmm. I know that in the past 2 years, many things have expanded to Zoom because of the inability to go places. Mm-hmm. And all of my listeners I've heard from so far tonight are from out of state. Mm-hmm. So is there an option for people who maybe are not physically in Champaign County, but they don't know anywhere else to get ukulele or ukulele lessons?
Yeah, there's definitely an option. We've tried all sorts of different kind of Zoom-like, goings-on before. One of them, I kind of just recorded all of the classes and then uploaded them to a cloud kind of storage. But for our listeners who are maybe out of Champaign County, when you do register, just make sure to take note when you register that you are interested in the Zoom version, and then we'll make sure that that information gets to you one way or another.
Thank you.
Of course.
Oh, and just one follow-up, because my microphone was dead before. Term for a song that shifts from one language to another is macaronic or macaronic, like macaroni. And so it ought to be easier to remember than I have found it to be, but it's kind of a fun term. And Feliz Navidad is a prime example of that. So, all right. As you were. Oh,
good trivia question.
Yes. We are actually right about close to the bottom of the hour, so I'll just remind people with the station ID that you are listening to WEFT 90.1 FM Champaign, and this is Web Sessions with the Champaign Urbana Ukulele Jam.
You got it, or also known as CU Uke Jam. Okay, our next one tonight is going to be Let It Snow, popularized by somebody at some point, I'm assuming, but I don't know who it was. We're just going to play our version of it, though.
Well,
we're
the composers
have a lot of fun.
Are super famous, like Broadway-type composers, Sammy Kahn and Jewel Stein,
okay,
as it says here, but they're known names for a certain generation, I guess.
Okay, let's give it a shot.
Outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I've bought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow. Finally kiss goodnight. How I hate going out in the storm.
But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm.
The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I've bought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, when we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm.
right, awesome. Awesome, awesome. The next song we're going to be playing is by one of my favorites, Wham. Another earworm for you. This is going to be Last Christmas. And then we'll learn a little bit more about the club. I think we've got some funny anecdotes lined up for you. We'll see. I want to get Kevin on the mic, but that's neither here nor there. All right, let's go ahead and give Last Christmas a try.
I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special.
Once bitten, twice shy, I keep my distance, but you still catch my eye. Tell me, baby, do you recognize me? Well, it's been a year, it doesn't surprise me. I wrapped it up and sent it with a note saying, I love you, I meant it. Now I know what a fool I've been, but if you kissed me now, I know you'd fool me again.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special.
Wham!
Wham again.
All right, so we are the CU Uke Jam. Thank you so much for tuning in to WEFT 90.1. We're having a really good time. I know a lot of us, except for Terry, have never been really in the studio before, so this is a real treat.
I was a WEFTie, so I did air shifting and all this stuff many, many years ago. And so, like, once a WEFTie, always a WEFTie. Seriously. They're like family.
Is it on now? I should let you do the underwriting.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, in other news, I've never seen so many CDs before. This is very cool. Cool.
It feels like home because my dad has a room like this.
Uh-huh. Oh. Yeah, nice. Sure.
Yeah, everybody else walks in here. They're like, I've never seen this before. Right? Yeah, this actually, if it just had a piano. And we used to, but it predated me. Apparently, when they got me, they got rid of the piano. So. And the record players.
Yeah.
No. I remember the couch.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, yeah.
We used to tell people, come sit on the couch and be our audience. And then we said, we got rid of the couch. Don't come be our... I mean, right now, with our policies, we don't have an audience. So, well, we have Charlie here.
But... Ooh, thanks, Charlie. We appreciate you.
He's more than... Here. Yes. Well, and Mike mixes it for the radio, so it's going to sound better on the radio than it would probably even in some parts of the room. So
cool. That's good news.
Well, there are times I can't hear myself, but everybody can hear me but me. Hmm. Yeah. Which is always kind of weird. You know, it's like screaming in space.
We can hear you scream in space.
Oh, you should patent that.
Yeah.
I'm sure that nobody's ever. I like it.
So is there an insulating factor to all these CDs?
I'm sure there is. Yeah. I don't know what the factor is, but I'm sure it exists.
Can I give an anecdote about my weft?
I would love
time?
That.
Oh, big time.
Well, first of all, back in my day in the 90s, we did have lots of vinyl here too. But I did a 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. show, which was very difficult, and I pretty much would have to stay up all night in order to make sure I was up, but I was young so I could do it and then go to work, whatever. But one time I didn't have a car, and so I rode my bike through some, you know, at least a couple of inches of snow, like powdery snow, just like having a really hard time with my backpack full of my own CDs. And I got stopped by the cops to say, you should really have lights on your bike. And I should have, because it was dark still at 6 a.m. But I mean, so.
Well, back in the 90s, they hadn't invented bike lights
exactly.
yet, I remember.
For sure. It's so
Two
true.
Questions.
Probably wasn't wearing my helmet.
What?
Anyway.
Did you have a DJ name?
No, but my show was called Weft of Center.
Oh, I think
we I
remember hearing about that.
Nice. I like that.
I think we overlapped a bit because I definitely knew your name and all that.
Oh, well,
I was only
you.
Here on the air for a little over a year, but yeah. But my Weft people are still great friends, even though we've all spread out everywhere.
Well, I know we have some open slots in the schedule if you
I've
ever
want to try and do it.
If you ever want to ride your bike in the snow down here again and with lights this time.
Yep.
What's the next training?
You know, they have them about three times a year, but I think they also try to fast-track people if... I'm not making any promises, but I think the next training is when enough people let them know they need a training. So we can't really afford to turn away good volunteers right now, I don't think.
So cool. Mm-hmm.
Again, the views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of the board of directors, blah, blah, blah. But that is my... unofficial opinion to encourage people that if they want to get involved, we certainly could use more involvement.
Is there an age limit?
I mean, it helps if you can talk and you're toilet trained, but I think that's about it.
One out of two.
I think it's like there used to be board games, fun for ages 2 to 102 or something like that. So as long as you're of I started to say you're of sound mind, but that would probably
sound. Uh-oh. Sound
if you are old enough to talk and aren't so old that you can't anymore, then that would probably make you a prime candidate, overqualified.
She'd be great.
So yeah, whatever age you are, the fact that you were able to ask the question, I think you're good.
Can I make one shout out to my Weft friends? Because this is actually pretty significant.
I feel like you should ask his permission.
Oh.
I'm fine with it.
Oh, you're good. You're good.
So, and I'll try and show them this video. So my friends, Michael John Nikolic and Scott Hermanson, were instrumental in changing the format of Weft's programming through the programming committee to what it still is now, like blocks, consistent blocks every day, like a morning show, a jazz show, a blues show, a world beat show, because before then things were all over the place and people really didn't know what they would hear at what times.
Are you saying Weft at one point was chaotic and disorganized?
Go figure. Yeah.
I don't even think a community radio station is allowed to be chaotic and disorganized.
So, but they really, I mean, it was a huge deal. So yay, guys. Also Kevin Holm Hudson and Lynn Daisy and Karen Holm Hudson. Anyway, my friends. So yeah,
friends are good.
That's all.
If I could make a quick shout out as well, I'd like to shout out my grandmother, Joanne Savage, who actually originally bought me this ukulele about 2.5 years ago and was the one who gave me the idea to start this kind of ukulele programming with the jam and the lessons and everything. As Kevin and some of the other members can attest here, I actually started with no ukulele knowledge at all. I just decided I'm going to teach a class and I'm going to learn with the people in my first class. And I can't believe they're still here today, to be honest, because that must have been a brutal first couple of classes, but really a lot of fun. And we have a great time and it's all free.
Well, let me just throw something out. You said if I'm allowed to make a shout out or it's your hour collectively.
Just so, kind of keeping an eye on the time.
Unless
think
you think somebody
time.
Out of your own peer group is going to be upset, you could do the rest of the show and just make it shout outs and you wouldn't get to the song.
We should do that at the end. I have a few people. At least one fan.
You don't need my explicit permission is all I wanted to say, because it's your hour to do what you want with collectively. So
just finished by 11.
But what do you have for us next?
Well, what I have next and what I want to do is do a quick solo piece. Mm-hmm. I'm a big fan of Bing Crosby, especially around Christmas time. So I'm going to be doing a rendition of White Christmas. And one really interesting part about this rendition, it's actually from a YouTube channel called Uke Underground. So if anybody wants to learn how to play exactly what I'm playing tonight, they can go to YouTube, type in Uke Underground White Christmas or Ukulele White Christmas, and it's the first video that'll come up, almost guaranteed. It's a really great version of the song, at least in my opinion. Hopefully I can do it some justice here in a second. And lastly, I'm going to be incorporating something called a looper pedal, which is going to be recording my strumming pattern, and then I'm going to play a fun little solo over it if all goes as planned. All right, thank you so much, everyone. And thank you to our listeners out there. We're having a lot of fun tonight.
Woo!
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. The tree tops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write. May your dreams be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be. Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your dreams be merry and bright, and may all of your Christmases be white. Christmases be white.
Yeah, Jacob.
Thank you.
Jacob Johnston.
Thank you.
Well, he doesn't need us anymore.
Really?
So we just got a call, and my mic's dead, so I'll wait.
You're on.
We just got a call from Aaron and Darcy, wanting to express appreciation for ukulele Christmas music. I said I would relay the message if I could get a word in, which, since my mic was turned off, was prescient. I think there was surprise that I, you know, on my show might not be able to, but I don't like to make promises until I know I can keep them, and now I have delivered the message. So thank you.
Sweet. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate you out there.
Thanks for listening.
I've said a show without listeners can still be nice, but a show with listeners actually reaching people, it's nice to know that people enjoyed it. So, and there have been more positive comments on the internet that I'll try to share.
Oh, comments. Nice.
There are positive comments on the internet.
Don't read the negative ones.
Pretty rare.
If you filter your channels, sometimes it helps to limit what you read to people you know and not random drive-by evil people.
All right, our next song is going to be the Chipmunks song, or... what's it called? Christmas Don't Be Late, I believe?
Chipmunk song.
Yeah, popularized by the Chipmunks and their dad, whose name escapes me. What's the dad's name?
Dave.
Is it Dave?
Dave Seville.
Dave Seville, the dad.
So the interesting thing about this piece, if you haven't looked it up, you can look it up and get a better story than this. It's all recorded by the same guy, singing the different parts, just really, really slowly and sped up.
Okay, that makes sense to me. That makes sense to me.
And really beautiful harmonies.
Harmonies.
Alvin, Theodore, and Simon.
Yeah.
They're not all here tonight.
No. Couldn't book them. Too expensive.
Okay, and we're going to have an introduction by Steve Sauce Steve. So go ahead, and whenever you're ready, Steve, take it away.
Here it goes.
Christmas, Christmas time is near. Time for toys and time for cheer. We've been good, but we can't last. Hurry, Christmas, hurry fast. Want a plane that loops the loop? Me, I want a hula hoop. We can hardly stand the wait. Please, Christmas, don't be late.
Sing this song all by myself.
I'm ready. Okay.
Christmas, Christmas time is near. Time for toys and time for cheer. I've been good, but I can't last. Hurry, Christmas, hurry.
Nice job, Alvin, a.k.a. Rachel. I think we've got maybe a little bit of a funny story about how we found that song, or at least decided to do it. We are at the Winter Nights from the Champaign Park District playing a quick 30-minute gig. And Matt, do you remember the gentleman who was playing before us? His name by chance? Oh, I'm kicking
Bill
myself.
Bill Kirby, I believe.
Bill, I believe it was Bill. Okay, Bill Kirby. I'm going to take your word for it, Matt. Bill Kirby was playing a really nice rendition of that song, and I think Matt and I both had the same idea right off the bat. Ooh, we're going to steal that.
Yeah.
So we found a couple of versions online. We're still kind of fiddling around with it and seeing which version we like the best, but that's the one we picked for tonight, and I liked it. So hopefully the listeners at home did too. For our next song, we're going to do step away from Christmas music for just a moment, or holiday music for just a moment, and we're just going to play one of our club staples. Another one that Matt found, this is the ukulele song, popularized by like Disney Channel or something. We're still not sure exactly where the origins of the song come from, but
this one did not make Disney Selling Songs Volume 1. It is only be found on Volume 2. I searched over the entire internet to try to find a copy of it. It was not on the internet. It did not make the internet.
The whole internet.
I had to go to the Champaign Public Library and check it out to find it.
Nice.
And once I listened to the Minnie Mouse version, I was like, yes, once again, the CU ukulele jam does it better.
And just a warning here, we're going to have a little kazoo in the studio. So more of just a warning to the sound guy than anything. There's no way, quiet way to play a kazoo, as it turns out. So I'm going to try to get very far away from this microphone while we're playing. But I hope you enjoy this one. I think it's definitely one of our favorites. And then we'll hit you with maybe one more Christmas song after this. All right, thank you so much. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Everybody ought to play the ukulele. Then you can play the ukulele like I do. You can swing on a star with your little guitar, making music all the hula ladies do the hula too. Everybody ought to play the ukulele, and the world be such a happy place to be. Why don't you be like me and pick up the ukulele and play the ukulele like I do?
I almost forgot to introduce the best part of that song, and that's got to be Kevin on the spoons. That's so fun.
So is this a point where we admit to having a hired professional or a former professional?
It's true. Kevin, you got any funny anecdotes for us or anything? Kevin was a professional percussionist for a good long time, knows everybody in the music business. I mean,
I might
that's
have
crazy.
A joke for you.
All right, let's hear our joke, Kevin.
All right, two snowmen are standing on a corner. One snowman leans over to the other one and says, "It smells like carrots."
Mm-hmm.
What did Mrs. Claus say to Santa when Santa asked her how's the weather? She replied, "Rain, dear."
Wah, 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 wah.
First of all, don't have
a mic that works.
There you go.
From up front, it sounded like you said, "It smells like Paris," and I was trying to figure out why that was funny, and then I thought about snowmen, and it made a lot
carrots.
More sense.
Carrots. Oh, yes.
Smell
don't give
carrots.
That microphone, though.
Yeah. There's a big joke saying, never give a drummer a microphone.
Uh-oh.
But you're not drumming tonight.
No, but it's in my soul, you know.
I know, but we you know.
He's always drumming somewhere.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Even if it's on an ukulele.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So he was at the Navy Pier, 17,000 people in the audience, and he does a what on the microphone?
Oh, so I'm playing at Navy Pier. It's a big gig, and they gave me a microphone. Somebody actually said, "Hey, would you like a microphone?" I said, "Sure, I'd love a microphone at sound check." So I'm behind this huge drum kit, you know, picture all these people. And behind the kit, I'm going, boo, boo, like electronic drums. And then I had to do the bomb. Not realizing there's 17 mics on the drum kit. So if I'm sitting on a stool, it's coming through. And I have a mic now, though. But so I'm really... Anyway, so the big joke was, thank gosh I wasn't fired. I was in a lot of trouble, though.
Oh.
And the new saying was, never give a drummer a microphone. Don't ever do it. So.
Well, I hope there are... I hope there's a reasonable exemption clause. Exception, exemption.
That's we right. kind of broke it tonight, and I'm glad
yeah.
we did.
Yeah. Now, quick question. Do you have one more or two more?
We got one more.
Okay. I want to make sure I'm hopefully good and ready by the end to start the next hour. So.
Okay. Sounds good. We'll finish it off with We Wish You a Merry Christmas. And just a big old thank you to WEFT Radio here for having us tonight. This has been an absolute dream for me, and I'm hoping to come back soon.
Oh, and I've got a shout-out. One last really quick.
All right, Matt's got a shout-out.
Thank you, Mike Ingram, for setting this up for us.
Oh, big time. Thank you, Mike Ingram.
Thank
That's
you,
true.
Mike Feldman, for the sound yes. and video. And Charlie, don't know your last name, for setting stuff up, too.
Charlie, the audience member.
Yes.
Thanks for
audience.
The clap.
Thank you so much, everybody. I think that's going to be it.
Are you sure you can't do an encore?
What's the encore?
One more song.
Yeah, one more song would
be great.
Can we do 5'2" or what was the other one? Oh. We don't know that.
Let's see.
Yeah, we don't have music for it. We do like.
Do you have anything for us, Steve? Do you want to do like a solo thing? Dead air. Second attempt. Yeah. Tell a joke. Do you got any more jokes for us, Kevin?
Probably.
What do you call an obnoxious reindeer?
Oh.
A Rudolph.
Oh. Rude.
You're going to try these at school tomorrow, right, Mia? You know, try all these jokes out?
No.
Someone just... you don't think they're high school qualified?
I'm good, thanks.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Gotta say, I love you being here, Mia, because I am no longer the youngest. That is nice.
Where do snowmen keep their money?
Snowbanks.
Yep.
All right. Finally. She woke up. She woke up. Oh, my gosh.
I could do a quick Mr. Sandman.
Oh, Mr. Sandman. Oh, we could rip off Mr. Sandman. Awesome. Yeah, let's give that a go.
Everybody, join in.
Mr. Sandman?
Are you missing something, Steve?
Sorry, it's missing.
Okay, let's do Mr. If we can rip off Mr. Sandman, let's roll that one.
Yeah. Let's just do it. Let's do Mr. Sandman.
Not everybody has it.
It's GNC.
Rough cut.
Rough
Mr.
Cut.
Sure, why not?
What we're gonna
I
work
love
on.
It. It's an actual youth jam. There we go.
Right. Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you so much to our listeners out there. We really appreciate the time. We have been the CU Uke Jam. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us through the Urbana Park District brochure. Come join us. You can sing along next time we're on WEFT. Why not? And thank you so much for your time tonight, everybody. And a merry holiday to you all.
Hello to Beth, Monty, Renan, Sarah, and maybe Sarah, and I don't know, you might be listening.
Shout out to